everybody. Dave Brown here at ringside with Corey Macklin. We're set to go with another day of USWA Championship Wrestling. Big one coming up this week.
Oh, big show today. We have indeed a young man that's been in the area for some time, left a while. He's back today. Ricky Morton, he's going to be in about today. We'll see Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert teaming up with Mike Sample. That's going to be an interesting tag match going against the Hornet and Tony Falk. Then we'll see Brian Christopher. He's scheduled for a single bout here today. Mean Mike Miller and Billy Joe Chavez, they had a single bout last week. Didn't have enough time for it. We're going to give them more time today. It's to the expiration of time. Promoter Eddie Marlin has signed it. And that's not all. Also, was told right before the program here today, Moondogs with Richard Lee, they're going to be out here against the King and Jeff Jarrett right there in the ring today.
How that's right. That yeah, something special in that match. We'll tell you about that when we come back in just a moment. Days ago, the Moondogs and Richard Lee put those World Tag Team titles on the line against Jerry Lawler, Jeff Jarrett, and the special referee was the original Fabulous One, Jackie Fargo. Now, after the match, brand new champions in Lawler and Jarrett, but let me tell you, Richard Lee is most upset about the situation.
Oh, yeah.
Take a look at this video. I got to tell you, if anybody is should be upset about it, should be Jackie Fargo.
Yeah.
Watch for yourself. Well, you saw exactly what happened. We do have new champions, but much to our surprise, just a few minutes ago, just a couple of minutes, as Corey mentioned, we have found out that a rematch has been scheduled. Now, a rematch was scheduled for later on this coming week. We found out it is going to be today. Right here. Jeff and Jerry have agreed to it. Here they come right here. You know, I'm thrilled we're going to have the rematch. It's always great to have world title matches here, but you know, they have 30 days to grant a rematch, and I just wonder what prompted to move the rematch up to today rather than be at the arena later on this week. Jeff, congratulations, Jerry, on having those belts around your waist there.
It feels awful good. You know, just like me and Jerry were watching in the back, you know, it's been 7 months coming.
Mm-hmm.
And Monday night, I couldn't have been, I really can't explain the feeling I had in there. I know we're supposed to be out here talking about what the match is fixing to take place, but I just want to say a little bit about Jackie Fargo and Jerry Lawler. I guess the two guys that I've tried to, that I've looked up to most in the wrestling business would have to be Jerry Lawler and Jackie Fargo. And to have them two in the ring, And one of them is one half of the world tag champs. I couldn't say more. I couldn't be more happier, Dave. Well, I'll let Jerry talk about today.
I understand, and I was a little surprised you're not wanting to celebrate longer rather than agreeing to the rematch today. Can you fill us in on that?
Well, I can, yeah. What, you're exactly right. What we want to do is have a little celebration. We want to have a celebration at the expense of the Moondogs and Richard Lee. Now, you're right. They said the match was already signed. But Richard Lee apparently went to Eddie Marlin this morning and said that if he would have, if we would give him the match here on television, where everybody could see it, that he would be willing to put up $5,000 in cash money, right here. He's going to have to bring it out and set it right here on this table, and then we're going to have this match, and anything goes now. This is so. I want everybody in this audience. You people on the front row, if there's seatbelts on those benches there, fasten them down or either move back a few rows, because when the Moondogs and Jeff Jarrett and the King get in the ring, with anything goes, we're liable to be all over this studio. So just get ready for that. And what you can also get ready for is at the end of this match, you're going to look at two young guys right here that are going to have $5,000 to celebrate with, and we're going to throw a big party with that $5,000. Yeah, so get them out here.
Get ready.
Come on, Richard Lee. Bring your dog and bring your money right now.
Well, I understand now. No wonder they signed the match.
Yeah.
Huh? $5,000 in cash.
Hey, here comes Lee and them, yeah.
Well, he's got a briefcase with him. I tell you what, let's check it and make sure there's money in there.
Put it right over here, Richard.
Richard Lee.
Put it over here. You done jumped me once. Dave Brad, I'm going to say something. It's a sorry state of affairs when two grown men can come out and literally steal two heavyweight tag team belts. But that's all right. I've been in meetings all week with Mike Samples. I had to meet with Eddie Marlin today. And I'm going to tell you something, Dave Brown. I'm not a happy man. I want you to know that, and I want everybody else to know that. Richard Lee lives up to his word, baby. Give me a shot up here. Give me a shot. And these people, you blue-collar workers that don't know what $5 is, this is $5,000, baby. It's my hard-earned money. It's my dog's hard-earned money. When this thing's over, I'm taking my $5,000 back with me. I'm taking the tag belts back with me. And I'm going to leave them with bloody faces, baby. And that's the fact. Dave Brown, you watch this. Corey Macklin's already jumped me several times from behind, and I'm not going to have him taking my money.
We'll watch the money, all right. We'll keep an eye on it. You head to the ring, and there go the Moondogs. And referee Frank Morrell calls for the bell. Corey, we've got a World Tag Team title rematch underway right here. The belts are at stake.
Belts at stake, not only that, $5,000 in cash. Richard Lee's brought it in, and not only did they bring that money in, they got some golf clubs in the ring over there.
They get treated like grown men, and they're going to take a beating like a pump sale.
Well, we'll have to see about that. But the Moondogs, jumping Lawler and Jeff out of the way already.
Here's Eddie Marlin out here. Eddie, the money's in there. You better check.
Okay.
Hey, that's a good point. Yeah.
Yeah, Eddie said he's going to watch the money to make sure Richard Lee doesn't grab it and run off with it.
Want to make sure the case was closed tight, because he doesn't want to grab a handful and try to save at least part of it. If the Moondogs lose and Richard Lee goes running out of here trying to salvage the money.
Oh, boy. You see him now, all over there. Cujo. Oh, the Moondog had a cover on Jeff. He got a two count out of it. Cujo nails Lawler, sends him down again.
Ooh, they got Lawler cut open.
Got him busted open, and they just rammed Jeff into the chair there. Moondog spot takes Jared and rams him into the metal chair again. Then Richard Lee's holding up right outside of the ring. And Moondog spot. What a headbutt on Jeff. Go for a pin cover. He's got him covered. One, two. Only two, though.
Richard Lee has hit Lawler in the face again with that chair. Got him right on right where he's cut, above his right eye.
Well, you see Cujo outside of the ring there working over Lawler, too. Spot's got a pin cover. One, two. All in two on Jeff, and Lawler's still staggering outside of the ring. He gets in the ring there now, finally. Spot's got Jet. Jarrett, reversal here. Takes the Moondog into the hole. Clothesline takes him down. Right out in the middle of the ring. Jeff got a pin cover. One.
Oh, a new chair.
Hey, Billy Joe Travis comes in, tosses in a garbage can for Lawler and Jarrett. They got to even things up now with these Moondogs. Look at Lawler working over Cujo. With the lid from that garbage can, he's working him over. Jeff grabs the ball.
He's right there. I've been talking about that. Billy Travis ain't got any business in out here.
Yeah, you don't have any business interfering yourself.
Yeah, who brought the first chair out here, Richard Lee? It was your guys. You had it in your hand as you headed out this way. And it's just sort of even things up with other hardware being brought in.
Exactly.
Boy, my goodness. What a match.
Dave, you talk about stuff, a ring full of everything. It's for the World Tag Titles and $5,000 that Richard Lee has decided he wants to put at stake. Here today, and Lawler and Jarrett have the belt, and boy, wouldn't be anything sweeter than go home with those titles and $5,000 in cash with you also.
Boy, I tell you, when these four get together, look out. It's tough to contain it in one ring. One of the Moondogs is cut open pretty bad, too, there.
Yeah, Cujo. Hey, look at Lawler's got him covered. He got it! One, two, three. Lawler and Jarrett get the win. How about it? The $5,000 suit. Hey, Jeff, don't forget the money over here.
That's two in a row for Jarrett and Lawler.
They win it.
They retain the belt. They're still the world champions. And they've just won a suitcase full of money here. $5,000. The Kings opening it up. The Moondogs are unhappy, let me tell you. There's the money right there.
Yes, sir. Keith's got that briefcase. He and Jeff just walk out of here with $5,000 and the World Tag Team titles. How about it?
Jerry opening up the case. Richard Lee is livid. Now Frank Morrell has just handed the World Championship belt back to Jerry Lawler and Jeff Jarrett. They have won them right here again on TV today. They won them earlier. And they have successfully defended here today. And they have taken only the belts, but they have also taken Richard Lee's money.
Look at Lawler throwing the money out there.
Throwing some of the money out to the crowd. Yes, he did throw your money. They are still the World Tag Team Champions. Jerry Lawler, Jeff Jarrett will be back after this. When the Moondogs have been here, there's always destruction left behind. That's the middle of our ring. Where did that tire come from? Automobile tire. They're still out here complaining. Richard Lee. And Richard, I know you're upset, but listen to this. Listen to this. Before you say anything, let me review this situation. You demanded a rematch. You put up $5,000. Wait a minute. Lawler and Jarrett agreed to the rematch today, but they said you get the rematch today, but that's it. That's your rematch. Now you got to work your way up. No rematch, they said.
I want it done. I want a rematch. Jeff Jarrett came out here and held Cujo's leg. Jerry Lawler, Jeff Jarrett, you stole my money, punk, and I want a rematch, and I want it right there. Get Eddie Marvin out here.
Well, Eddie. I don't know if he's coming out here or not, because that was my understanding of the stipulation, wasn't it, yours? Mine too, that they got the rematch here today, and we didn't understand why, but then we found out the $5,000.
Enough is enough. I'm sick and tired of Jeff Jarrett and Jerry Lawler coming out here breaking the rules while my dogs wrestle by the rules.
I don't want to hear all that. What did you call me out?
I want a rematch, and I want it right now. I want my $5,000 back, and I want our tag belts that are rightfully ours. They stole them from us, and I want them back right now. I want a rematch.
Wait just a second, Richard Lee. You wanted a rematch, right? You just had your rematch. It was on TV, and you lost it, so it's no more rematch.
No. Eddie, I want a rematch. Go back and tell them right now, if you hear me on the monitors, Lord, you hear me, Jeff? I want a rematch. Tell him. Go tell him, Eddie.
Well, They've already.
This is ridiculous, Dave. Absolutely ridiculous,
Corey. Nothing ridiculous. You guys have just lost twice, and you're no longer the world champions after seven.
Go for me. $5,000, and it's highway robbery.
Did not steal any money. They won the match. They won the match that you put.
Pulled his leg and held him down. I want him out here.
They won the match fair and square. 1, 2, 3. Frank Morrell, the count fell. 1, 2, 3. And it was all. Here's Eddie Marlin shaking his head. Nope. No rematch.
I want him out here.
He asked him and they said no.
I don't care what they say. You either get him out here or I'm calling the police.
Conference between Lawler, Jarrett, and Eddie Marlin. I have no idea what they're saying. We don't have a microphone in that area, so. Well, the conference is over. No, conference is not over. It's going to continue here for a minute, it looks like. Moondog. Richard Lee wanting a rematch. They are no longer world champions, and they have lost $5,000 and the match today. Oh, okay. Me? All right, I can't get too close to you, guys.
Let me just say, all right, Richard Lee, here's our deal. You can take it or you can leave it. Not today. You're not getting the match today. Because we've got to have one match, and we have beat you, and we have got two teams. I'll tell you what we're going to do. Here's what we'll do. We'll go down to the Coliseum Monday night. Now listen to this. We'll put the tag team titles on the line with the stipulation. Anything goes, just like today. No disqualification, no stopping the match. Anything goes till somebody gets pinned. And when we pin your Moondog, you sit down in the middle of that ring and let Eddie Marlin shave every single hair. He shaved every hair till you're bald as a cue ball.
That's it. Take it or leave it.
That's the only way you're going to get the match.
He doesn't like that at all. Oh, my goodness. Uh-oh, Richard Lee's in trouble over here. Yeah, the Moondogs want this match, and now they're mad at Richard Lee for not agreeing to it here.
Oh,
what?
Hey, stop talking about shaving my hair.
Let me get back over here.
Listen up, big boy.
Watch it, Dave. Watch it over there.
But it's not going to be this way forever. You understand that? Either I take your deal or my dogs beat me up. Well, it's not going to happen that way, brother. The only beat my dog's going to do is on you two punks. And come Monday night, you're going to be without the belt and you're going to be without your heads because we're going to knock them off. Sign the contract, Eddie Marlin. Sign the contract.
The rematch looks like will be signed.
Dave, you heard Richard Lee, so sign the match. And this afternoon, I'm going to go out and buy me a nice new pair of clippers, some that will just cut that hair clean down to the skin.
All right.
Sign that match.
With a stipulation that if the Moondogs lose, Richard Lee's hair is history.
Nobody's going to get away with this, Dave Brown. It's all a stink button.
We will see, Richard Lee. You have told us the last two times that there was no way that they could win, but they have done it. They are the world tag team champions, and the Moondogs are. Richard Lee is still not happy. Look at him. He's walking out of here not happy at all, but he had no choice.
Yeah,
the Moondogs
no choice
wanted
at all.
To match.
Yeah, yeah.
And that will be, in fact, an anything goes match with his hair steak. Matter of fact, Let's just take a look at the entire card. Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. Another great night. Boy, what a great one last week with a tremendous crowd on hand.
Oh, indeed.
We hope you'll be back at the Mid-South Coliseum this Monday night. Mean Mike Miller with Lauren Davenport in the corner will be in the opening match against Billy Travis. By the way, that's the first of seven tournament matches to decide who will get a title shot at Tom Pritchard's Southern title. In case you haven't heard, Dr. Tom is now the Southern heavyweight champion, and this seven-match tournament will determine who gets to go against him for that title. That's the first match. The next of the preliminaries, the Hornet, will be going against Mike Samples. Following that, you got Moondog Spike against Tony Falk. And then Brian Christopher, the former champion, but look who he has drawn in this preliminary match in the opening round for the tournament. Eric Embry against Brian Christopher. And that's not all. After that, we'll take the winners of those four matches, bring them back in semifinals, and then the winners, of course, of the semifinals will go on to the finals, and the winner of the final match will be wrestling Tom Pritchard for the Southern heavyweight title. Unified World title match coming up. Rick Morton. Ricky Morton is coming in to go against the champion Hot Stuff, Eddie Gilbert. Get ready is right. Oh, man, what a match that should be with a unified world title at stake. And then, it's a double main event. The rematch has been signed. Now, the match was signed originally as the rematch, but then today there was the rematch. So now this match still will take place, according to Eddie Marlin, because Richard Lee has agreed that his head will be shaved if the Moondogs lose. It's Moondogs and Richard Lee going against Jeff Jarrett and Jerry Lawler. Titles are at stake. Anything goes. 8 o'clock Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. Make your plans right now to be there. Here's the King of Jeff right now.
Let me just say, for 7 months, things have gone the way of the Moondogs and Richard Lee, because Richard Lee is a pretty devious guy. He knows how to pull the wool over a lot of people's eyes. Well, Richard Lee, the wool has been pulled by you for the last time. The worm has turned, and you're looking at the new world tag team champions, and we're going to stay that way for just as long as your Moondogs had those belts. And the great thing about it is, after Monday night, Richard Lee, Tuesday morning when you wake up and look in that mirror, you're going to wonder if you're looking at yourself or a big cue ball, boy, because you're going to be bald as an onion. You understand what I'm saying? And you're hearing it from somebody that knows what it's like. I know exactly the feeling when you have to sit your rear end down in that chair and have several thousand people just sitting staring at you, and have somebody come in with some clippers and shave every hair off the top of your head. Richard Lee, I will promise you that it'll be the worst feeling of your life. But for me and Jeff Jarrett for all these thousands of wrestling fans, it's going to be the greatest day of our life, because I've been waiting for a long time.
That's right. You know, Dave, when everybody asks you, what's your most embarrassing moment in wrestling? Well, the guys who've had their head shaved automatically say, the night I had to sit in the ring in front of thousands of people and have your head shaved. Right. Well, Richard Lee, Monday night, that's going to be your most embarrassing moment. I thought last Monday was great for me with Jackie Fargo with the referee and Jerry Lawler as my partner, and we came out victorious. Well, this Monday night is going to be even better, because after it's all over, you're going to be a ball-headed. I can't wait.
We can't wait. Anything goes. That's from the nose to the toes. Get ready, boys. It's going to be a big one. And when it's all said and done, Richard Lee, we're going to call you Baldy for a long time.
Monday night, 8 o'clock at the Mid-South Coliseum. Back in a moment. USWA Championship Wrestling. We've got a world title match, a successful title defense. The unified world champion is headed this way right now. There he is, Hot Stuff, Eddie Gilbert. I see the crown, but I do see you've got the belt.
There's a problem here. You know, I realize all across our great country and nation right now that a lot of people don't like calling George Bush president, but he is our president. And you still, when you talk about George Bush, you say President Bush. So when you talk about Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, I would appreciate it, Dave Brown, if I could start hearing from you and Corey, the king of wrestling, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, the one and only unified world heavyweight champion. Now,
I got that out of the way.
Now, will you remember that for me, please?
Yeah.
This is actually a great day for me,
Because, you know, since I came back in the area and I had to wrestle so many goody-goody two-shoes, and then I finally wrestled Jerry Lawler, and I finally beat him, and I finally got the Unified World Heavyweight Championship, and then I had to go in matches against him all across this area. Then I had to go against matches against the Dirty White Boy. Then I had to go in matches against Dr. Tom Pritchard. And you know, and it gets so tiring after a while, Dave, of having to wrestle these goody, goody, goody guys that all the people love, and all you hear is go Jerry go, or go Tom go, or go Jeff go, or go Billy go. Well, finally, I have an opponent, ladies and gentlemen. I have a worthy challenger coming into the USWA to wrestle me for the Unified World Heavyweight Championship. A man that left this area just like me. A man that went on to great fame and fortune just like me. A man that has so many things in common with me. Egotistical, arrogant, conceited, self-confident, handsome. All of those things in one package, and that is Ricky Morton. A man that doesn't mind these people. A man that has my, I tell you what, a man that has all of my respect in professional wrestling. I don't really respect anybody in wrestling, but Ricky Morton has all my respect. I'm really looking forward to this match. There won't be any goody-goody two-shoe things. There won't be yelling, go, Ricky, go. There won't be, what? He's here?
He's here.
Coming right this way is Rick Morton. Yes, indeed.
I didn't know he was here.
Here he comes.
Ricky's here. Ricky, come here. Come here, Ricky. Ricky. Come on.
Sorry.
There you go.
Oh, okay. All right.
How you doing? All right. You know something, Dave? Wait a minute, Eddie. I sit here listening to you talk back here in the back. This is true. Yeah, I've been all over the country. Been 4 times world tag team champions. And I wrestled a lot of different places.
That's right. That's right.
As a matter of fact, I wrestled in places where people didn't like me too much. I didn't like them either.
I understand.
But let's stop right here. But when we talk about this area right here, Eddie Gilbert.
Sucks, doesn't it?
Huh?
Yeah, bad.
Well, let me tell you something, buddy. Without all these fans right here, that's one thing I got to say. Without all these fans right here, I would have never became Ricky Morton of the Rock and Roll Express because they stood behind me through thick and thin. No matter wherever I wrestled in the world, I didn't care about nobody. But I always talk about these people here because they are home,
no,
baby.
No, Ricky.
These people are nothing. The way that you and I made it in wrestling is forgetting about all these hicks, all these rednecks, all these people on welfare, all these people that look up to us as stars. That's what made us, not these people. Come on, come on. Just forget about them the way you have. Come on, forget. They're nothing. They're nobody. None of these people are anything. I made it by myself. I made it on my own, and so did you.
You know, Dave, I made a lot of mistakes in my life. And I made a mistake a long time ago when I turned on a partner of mine because we had some family business, some trouble we had to take care of. But I never, never forgot where I came from because, you see, I lost everything in my life. And when I lost that, I thought I lost the fans that stood behind me. And then I found out, brother, that I was nothing without all these people out here. So don't you come out here, brother, talking about people being on welfare because today, brother, it's hard to make a living. And these people right here, they stand behind me, and I'm going to stand in front of them.
These people stink. These people are nothing. All across this area, every town we go to, every town this television is seen in, every stupid, idiot person, illiterate person here today stinks, and you're going to stand up for them. Is that what you're telling me?
That's right, brother. Your opinion is like my behind. Everybody's got one, brother, and I told you my opinion.
Oh,
wow.
Yeah. Now, let me tell you something, buddy. You forget where your roots are. You forget what made you. It wasn't these stupid people here. You hear me? It wasn't these stupid people here. It wasn't you people. It was not you. It was not
you. Oh, my goodness, there in the ring. Ricky just nailed him with a right hand.
Oh,
and another one.
We're going to work over Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. Pulls him into the ropes. Eddie Gilbert hot tells the audience, too. He gets out of the area, and Ricky Morton, he just took Gilbert and slung him in the ring and went to work on it.
Well, instead of telling everybody how I feel, give me somebody out here I can wrestle.
All right, well, Rick was scheduled to go in a match,
yeah.
And, you know, I got to admire him because rather than say, all right, I took care of him, I'm out of here, he said, the fans are expecting a match, get me somebody out here to wrestle, and I'll wrestle him right now. Here comes the intruders stepping through the ropes. And referee Kevin Christian with the inspection. And Rick Morton will be going against the intruder here today. Boy, what action we've had. Here's Corey Macklin.
Thank you, Dave Brown. And Ricky Morton just goes to work on him, flips the intruder over, and goes to work on him immediately there, whips him into the rope, catches him with a clothesline, and takes him down. Ricky Morton back in the USWA. It's good to see him back, too. Picks the intruder up and just slams him down. Follows with the right hand on him. Takes the intruder. He's going for that mask of the intruder there now. Oh, look out, Ricky.
And now behind, Eddie Gilbert jumps him.
Oh, Gilbert comes in there. Oh, and Ricky with a reversal here. Big butt jump on Gilbert. Comes back with a forearm on him. Ricky Morton, boy, he's been to work it on Gilbert. Knocks him over the top rope. Picks the intruder up. Power slams him down. One, two, three.
He goes.
Ricky Morton. And rock and roller gets the win.
And he ran Eddie Gilbert out of here again.
Yeah,
he flipped,
two times.
Flipped Gilbert over that top rope, and Gilbert left. He's still going for that mask.
Hey,
he's got it off.
He got it off, too. Boy, Ricky Morton is coming today. There goes the intruder out of here. I think Ricky Morton just intruded on his mask in there and took it away from him. Ah. Ricky Morton, there he is, standing in the middle of the ring.
Look out for Rick when he meets up with Eddie Gilbert down the road. We'll be back in a moment. We got another tag team match coming up here that should be a great one. We got the Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert team with Mike Samples, and a lot of the wrestling fans who saw the outcome of Gilbert winning that Unified World title will certainly give Mike Samples a big assist. But they're going today against Tony Falk and the Hornet, who are already in the ring. Here comes Gilbert. He's not happy.
He's not going to get away with that. You say he attacked me from behind?
Oh.
The world champion, he jumped me from behind. I can't believe that. Anymore, let's all this stuff go. He's not going to get away with that.
You make sure when you introduce him, you call him the King of Wrestling.
I'll call the King of Wrestling the King of Wrestling. How about we make that deal? And it's not Gilbert. He is the Unified World Champion. He climbs into the ring with his partner Mike Samples to go against Tony Falk and the Hornet. It looks like it's going to be Tony starting against Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. And here we go.
Yeah, we're underway.
Boy, Samples is making all sorts of demands here today. Once Gilbert introduced as the king, and he wants the people thrown out.
Oh, look at Gilbert. Stepped up near the Hornet over there and kind of backed up. Yeah.
You know, Tony Falk and the Hornet have themselves quite an opportunity here, because Eddie Gilbert has just been run out of the ring twice by Rick Morton. You know, that had to shake his confidence a little bit.
Oh, yeah, indeed. Well, they had to throw him off track there or something, as you pointed out, Dave. Look at Gilbert there now. He's complaining. He pulled my hair. Hey, I tell you what, too, this Tony Falk and Hornet make a good team. We saw them last week here at USWA Wrestling, and they teamed up to be a good tag team in there. Gilbert comes off. He got Mike Samples and knocked Samples off the ring apron there.
Samples was holding Tony back in the corner, but Tony was able to break free rather easily from Samples when Eddie Gilbert had committed, and Gilbert ended up nailing his partner.
Knocked him right off the ring apron. Falk tags his partner, the Hornet, coming in. He wrestles out of Brewster, Washington, and some kind of young wrestler he is. Steps in the ring with Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, tags Tony Falk again. These two again work together good, tag in and out. Falk comes out the middle rope on Gilbert. They continue to work on that left arm of Hot Stuff. He's a self-proclaimed king of professional wrestling. Boy, did he want to be a king.
Yeah, that's been an obsession with Gilbert for a long, long time. He carries around a crown and all of that sort of thing. Now, that's not the way you become the king. You become the king by earning it.
Exactly. Look at Falk go under. Comes back. Nice takedown from Tony Falk. Takes Gilbert down to the mat. Good arm takedown on Hot Stuff. Yuba trying to reach over and tag his partner, Mike Samples. Samples up on the bottom rope now, stretching for the tag. Referee Frank Morrell gets him over there.
Yeah, that would not have been a legal tag. You got to have your feet on the apron and at least one hand on the turnbuckle to make it a legal tag. Of course, Frank Morrell wasn't about to allow him to stand on the ropes and lean in like that.
Oh, my.
Gilbert pulling hair there.
Yeah. Well, I had to pull Falk by his hair, and Tony just pulled him straight down to the mat. Tony Falk and the Hornet. Boy, what a lot of action we've had here today on USWA Championship Wrestling. This half has not been told yet either. Still got a lot more to go. Look at Samples.
Look at
down the middle rope.
This is ridiculous.
Boy. Samples trying to lean in on the middle rope there. He's halfway in the ring. Falk's action partner, the Hornet. Hornet comes in and works on that left arm of Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. Follow style with an elbow on Gilbert. Boy, this Hornet is really going to come on to be some kind of great wrestler. He's in now with the Unified World Heavyweight Champion, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. Boy, if you want to learn anything, I guess you must say you can learn it from the world champion.
Yeah, not sure you want to learn too much from Eddie Gilbert's style, though. He will do just about anything. You got to watch him very, very carefully.
Gets in the ring. Falk grabs that left arm again. They continue to work. Look at Gilbert. As you just pointed out, he'd do anything. Took Falk, threw him over the top rope.
Over the top rope. That would have been an automatic disqualification, except Mike Samples had the referee distracted on the other side, and Frank Morrell did not see him go over the rope. And now Eddie Gilbert is explaining, yes, sir, I threw him through those ropes. He went right through the top rope and the middle rope. That's exactly what happened, sir.
We're right over the top rope there. Nails Tony before Falk could get on the ring apron. Sends him back out on that concrete floor. And Gilbert, when he threw Falk over, just fell out in the middle of the ring as if to say, well, I got knocked out of that. Just laid out in the ring. Look at Tony Falk make his way back with a series of rights. Takes Eddie Gilbert, whoops him into the turnbuckle. Big back jump on Gilbert. He takes him down with it. Legs in on Gilbert. Look at Falk. He's got him set up now. Bulldog on Gilbert. He's got a pin cover. He's got him covered over there. Watch out for Mike Samples.
Yeah, the referee trying to get Hornet back outside, and Samples put something in his
hand.
What
in the world did he have?
I don't know.
What did he have in there? One in his pocket, and Gilbert got a pin cover three. Gets the win. That's the same kind of stuff. Same way Gilbert won the Unified World title with Samples helping him there.
Once again, it's Mike Samples interfering. This time, he had a foreign object in his hand. He nailed Tony Falk with it. And a very still very unhappy Eddie Gilbert collects the crown, collects the belt, and he and Mike Samples head out of here as the Hornet attends to his partner, Tony Falk, in the ring. Fans, let me take just a moment right here. Since we were with you last time, the wrestling world lost a big one. Earlier this week, Plowboy Frazier died at a hospital in Pascagoula, Mississippi. Most wrestling fans in this area knew Plowboy well. He was 7 feet tall. He weighed 485 pounds. He wrestled many different ways. He was sometimes the fans loved him, sometimes they didn't so much. But at one point, he was a partner with the King, Jerry Lawler. Stan Frazier was 54 years old.
At a time limit. There's the tag from Lawler to the Giant Hillbilly. Slip through the ropes, and that's no easy task in itself. Clobber spike upside the head. And again with a big right hand. JD strolling around the ringside. Slams JD down, does the Hillbilly. Drops with that big Mississippi splash.
You got a lot of action coming up the next few days around the territory.
Yeah, we've got a lot of it, including the King softball team. Today, from 1:30 until 4 p.m., Also, the King's going to be out at Fireworks City. Of course, today is the 4th of July. Mm-hmm. He's going to be out at Fireworks City at the Bridgeport exit there. That's right across the old bridge there in West Memphis. Free photos and autographs plus 144 bottle rockets.
Hey, and you know, one thing I forgot to mention, we were talking about the Memphis car. They're also going to give away that fireworks display to some lucky winner there. No purchase necessary Monday night at the Coliseum,
is, right
which you
there.
Can have a late celebration or you can save it for next year. But go ahead. Sorry to interrupt.
That's okay. Plus 144 bottle rockets the King is going to have out there today. At Fireworks City at the Bridgeport exit, that's right across the old bridge in West Memphis, you can get a bottle of rockets, 144 of them for only $1.29. That's less than a penny each. That's during the King's appearance only today from 1:30 until 4. Speaking of the King, he's going to be in Clarksdale this Friday night along with Jeff Jarrett, the World Tag Team Champions. 8 p.m. this Friday, Civic Auditorium there in Clarksdale, Mississippi. Moondogs will be out there and Hornet. A list of them there in Clarksdale. Coming up Friday, July 17th, Kennett, Missouri, the American Legion building there at 8 p.m. Moondogs, Jeff Jarrett, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert all on the card in Kennett, Missouri. Championship Wrestling coming to Jonesboro, Arkansas, Saturday, July 25th. There in Jonesboro on a Saturday night at 8 p.m., all of the USWA top stars. Coming soon to Shelby, Mississippi Championship Wrestling. Also, Thaxton, Mississippi, and Senatobia, Mississippi. All of the USWA top stars are lined up for USWA Championship Wrestling. That's action around the territory.
Have the World Tag Team Champions right here, and you guys got another busy week coming up.
Oh, man, I'll tell you what, a busy day today, especially, I thank you, Corey. You already mentioned that I'm going to be over at Fireworks City at the Bridgeport exit from 1:30. That'll be right after the show's over today, from 1:30 until 4 o'clock. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to spend some of Richard Lee's money. I'm going to tell you what I'm going to do. What's the favorite thing? Everybody likes to shoot bottle rockets. I'm going to, just while I'm there at that Fireworks City only, I'll pay whatever else it is. But anyway, 144 bottle rockets for $1.29. That's less than a penny a piece. Yeah. It's regularly about $5. I'll pay the rest, okay? So come and see me over at Fireworks City. Also, tomorrow now, at 1:30, everybody, I want to tell everybody up in Yorkville, Tennessee. There we are. Look at this. If you get a shot, we got half of Yorkville here today.
Yeah, lots of the towns here.
Lawler's Kings of Memphis going to be up in Yorkville, Tennessee, and we're going to be playing to raise money for the Yorkville T-Ball Association and the Little League Association. We're going to be playing the T-Ball Dads and the Little League Dads, but we've told them no mercy on them up there in Yorkville, so everybody come on out there tomorrow. That's at 1:30 at Yorkville City Park, and next week we're going to be in Middleton, Tennessee. So.
Okay, very good. Jeff?
A lot of things going on, Dave, but before I talk about Monday night, I want to talk about Friday night, Clarksdale, Mississippi, right down the Civic Auditorium. A lot of great matches, and also, I don't know if y'all mentioned, but don't forget the ball game, July 24th.
Oh, yeah, it's been rescheduled.
Over at Chick Stadium, and then don't forget Monday night. Richard Lee, going to shave his head
Monday night.
Got the Clippers ready. Eddie Marlin says going out right after the program today. Going to buy a fresh set that'll take it all the way down to the scalp this time around. A lot of fans really looking forward to seeing that, too.
Yes,
hey, something the fans got to see this past week. A new Southern heavyweight champion, too. The belt had been held up. Brian Christopher going against Dr. Tom Pritchard. Watch. Coming up right now, it's a little.
You got over there.
What is that? I don't believe this. Here's Brian Christopher. He has the Texas belt around his waist, but don't be misled. He is no longer the Southern Heavyweight Champion.
Scoot over,
what,
Dave.
What is this?
Scoot, hold your horses. Now hold your horses, Dave. Now last week, I came out here, and I showed the Brian Christopher video, didn't I? You remember that video I showed?
Oh, I remember it all right, yeah.
Yeah, with the homeless guy. And I picked him up, and I took him home, and made him do a little work, and then fed him pretty good. And you know what? The truth of it is, look, scoot over, Dave. The truth of it is, let me tell you a little truth. Before I picked up that homeless guy, I passed Corey Macklin with his little homeless sign. This guy right here, I passed him up, two blocks back, wanting to work for food. But listen, after I showed that video last week, this station was bombarded. I mean, that calls were coming in. Everybody wanted to see that video again. Oh, please show the Brian Christian video again. We all want to see it again. It was so good. Well, get your VCRs warmed up. Well, I forget who I'm talking to. You ain't got VCRs. You can't afford that. Well, anyway, I'm going to put a big toothless smile on your face because I'm about to show the Brian Christopher video one more time. So cue it up and let's watch it. The Brian Christopher video.
You heard their reaction. I trust we won't have to look at that anymore.
That's because they're all homeless, too. They're jealous they didn't get a can of Spam. But anyway, Dave, I know you're wondering what this is. Can you read? I told y'all last week I'd get a big Oscar for that performance, for that video. And sure enough, straight from Hollywood, get it close for that. Get it close up. Get it close up. Can you read that, Dave? Corey, can you read that?
Best wrestling video ever, Brian Christopher.
That's right. That is right. I'm amazed you can read, Dave. I got my big Oscar this week. They're jealous. You're jealous. I can see it in your eyes.
I just can't believe it.
Okay. Well, listen. You know, this should have been one of the happiest weeks of my life. I showed my video. I got my big Oscar. But you know what? The big scam was pulled. The big scam on old nice guy Brian. I ain't never hurt nobody. I been nice to everybody I've ever met. But they pulled the big scam. Eddie Marlin and Tom Pritchard
and you were probably in on it. They pulled the big scam where he took my Southern title. He took my Southern title. And you know, usually when the champion, if somebody, you know, steals their belt, they get a return match. But no, 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 not me, not Brian Christopher. I got to go through the tournament to get a rematch. Well, I'm going to tell you what, everybody. I'm going to breeze right through that tournament. And then I'm going to take back my Southern title. And then I'll be the happiest camper in the whole Mid-South area. And now, Dave, I'm about to step in this ring and show you what a real champion is made of.
Well, he's going to...
Take good care of my Oscar. I don't want anybody touching it.
Well, I would certainly hate for anything to happen to that fine work of art. The, what I guess, major award that Brian Christopher... I'm going to move it out of the way here because I can't see what's going on for that thing. He steps into the ring, and we are about set to go with another single match. Referee Kenny Christian calls for the bell. It sounds, and here we go.
Brian Christopher tells the referee, watch my new boots. Brian Christopher and his opponent, John Parsley.
Well, I'll tell you what.
He's something with that mouth.
He is something else.
Angled up with Parsley, backs him up against the turnbuckle. That slapped Parsley. But reversal here, Parsley whips him into the turnbuckle. Sets Christopher up for a hip toss. Ron Christopher just slammed him down. Boy. He slammed Parsley straight down to the mat. Big foot on Parsley takes him down. Christopher didn't like it at all, and Parsley almost had him going there for a moment.
Yeah, Parsley embarrassed him, but Christopher came right back and has taken control. Big body slam. He had his fist double when he dropped on him that side. Oh, wow. Referee told him to watch the fist, so he opened the hand up and just slapped him, just sort of an insult.
Just rubs that boot right on the face of John Parsley. Takes Parsley, works that short clothesline on him, and takes him down. Now, Christopher can get a pin and probably win the bout in here, but no, he just wants to humiliate Parsley. Falls down with that neck breaker on him.
That ought to wrap it up if he goes for the pin, but he's not going to do it. Look, he's stepping out. He's going to climb the rope. There he goes.
He's got to do more. He's up on the top one there now. Brian Christopher, Oscar and all, comes out on Parsley with a big right leg. One, two, he got it.
That's
well,
it.
He gets the win.
Well, it turned out to be quite a mismatch, actually. We didn't know much about Parsley coming in, but Brian Christopher upset, frankly, that he is no longer the Southern Heavyweight Champion. He came out here with this goofy award that he claimed to have won for his video. He does get a victory here today.
How'd you like it, Dave?
Well, are
impressed?
You...
They're all jealous. I got the Oscar. I got the tag title. I'm taking Tom Brady.
There he goes, Brian Christopher, Oscar under his arm. We'll be back after this. Big night coming up Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. 8 o'clock is when it all begins. Don't forget about the big fireworks giveaway that Lawler was talking about. And again, this week, of course, no purchase necessary for the big fireworks giveaway. 7-match tournament will decide who gets a shot at Dr. Tom Pritchard's Southern title. Opening match, Mean Mike Miller with Lauren Davenport in his corner will be going against Billy Travis. Then it'll be the Hornet going against Mike Samples. Moondog Spike goes against Tony Falk. Brian Christopher will be going against Eric Embry. That should be some kind of match right there. Then we'll bring them back in semifinal matches. The winners of the semifinals will go in the finals to decide who wrestles Tom Pritchard for the Southern Heavyweight title. Then the Unified World title is going to be on the line. Hot stuff, Eddie Gilbert puts it on the line against...
Ricky, boy, did he look good today.
Yes, he did. Rick Morton, and I think Eddie Gilbert thought, hey, we're just going to come out of here and two old buddies together. You know, he breaks the rules, I break the rules. He doesn't like fans. Well, Ricky Morton straightened him out on that and ran him out of here twice, too. Then World Tag Team title match. Anything goes. Richard Lee's hair is at stake as Jarrett and Lawler set out to defend the World Tag Team titles against the Moondogs and Richard Lee. 8 o'clock Monday night is when it all happens at the Mid-South Coliseum. Here is Eric Embry right here, one of the participants in this tournament coming up.
You know, Dave, I was going to come out here, and the Southern Heavyweight title is the ticket to the World Heavyweight Championship.
That's it.
And I was going to come out here, I was going to talk about how I was going to win the tournament, I was going to face Dr. Tom, I was going to take the title, then I was going to knock on your door, Eddie Gilbert. But you know, Dave, I wasn't here last week, and I just saw the most sickening thing I've seen in my whole life. I saw the Brian Christopher video. Well, Brian, I've listened to you run your mouth month after month after month, man, about how bad you are. But, man, when you start knocking the underprivileged people, the people that can't help where they're at, man, I'm not worried about the Southern Heavyweight title. I'm coming after you Monday night. And what do you want, hot shot?
Mike Sample's also got a match coming up.
First off, you're wasting your time out here talking, running your mouth, filling the room with hot air. You have no chance. I'm here to take care of business, and I will be the new Southern Heavyweight Champion.
Let me tell you something, Mr. Official, or whatever in the heck you are. It's real simple. Brian Christopher makes fun of the homeless people, the underprivileged people. Well, Eric Embry's going to stand up for those people. And let me tell you something, hotshot. I'm from Texas, too. And if you don't get back behind the desk where you belong, when I get through with Christopher, I'll come knocking on your door.
Has the makings for quite a night, Monday night at the Coliseum. We'll be back here after this. Miller, and that's Lauren Davenport talking to referee Frank Morell as he steps through the ropes. Here comes Billy Travis. He's got that fine-looking robe. He's heading this way. Hey, Billy.
You know, last week I said I didn't know too much about Mike Miller. This week I know a little bit more. And Miss Davenport, let me tell you something. If you smack me like you did last week, I'm going to stick my fist right down your throat, and I promise you.
Billy Travis on his way to the ring. We got an expiration of time match coming up here. Should be a good one. Referee calls for the bell.
We got some unfinished business to take up here today, Brandon. It'll take about 30 seconds.
That's the word from Lauren Davenport. Billy Travis has told her she better stay out of it. Now she's not going.
Look at Billy! Off that turnbuckle. Travis flipped him over. Only got two, though.
Mean Mike Miller coming in out of the west coast of Portland, Oregon, working Billy Joe Travis over. Flips Billy over, falls down, and that's the one right hand. Takes Billy Joe, whips him into the ropes again. Boy, hey, not like he has something, like he got that glove on his hand, Mean Mike Miller. Those leather gloves, he caught Travis with it too. Jabs him in the throat. Reversal here. Miller comes off the turnbuckle. Tips off from Travis. Arm drag, and he's got Miller down on the mat. Hold it on that left arm of Mike Miller. Billy Joe Travis and Mike Miller. Travis, look at... Look out. Travis scoots out under the bottom rope. Goes after Lauren Davenport. Mean Mike Miller steps out of the ring to protect her, gets in between Billy Travis and Lauren. Oh, Travis just smacked him with a big, big, powerful right hand.
Boy, you can hear that link all over the studio here.
Drops down on Miller off that top rope. Takes Mike Miller, whips him into the rope.
Look at Miller with a sunset flip on Billy.
Didn't work.
Travis gets loose, gets his own pin cover. He's got two, and Miller kicks out of him.
Billy Travis refused to go down to the mat after the attempt at the sunset flip. Instead, he doubled up that fist. He did indeed do that and nailed Mike with it.
Good bow to the expiration of time.
Mean Mike Miller, don't forget about Lauren Davenport, who was his valet over in the corner.
Don't forget about her at all. William Miller go to work on Travis, just slams down with a few right hands, slams him into the turnbuckle, and again he slams Billy. Got him, hey, oh,
look out.
Look out.
Well, Lord over there, they're slapping, Travis. Billy had his hands on it there, Charlie.
He had that fist pulled back, too, but Mike Miller was able to pull him back before he could smack her.
Yeah, I wish he could have got a leg over there himself. Look at Travis go under, comes back, and Miller catches him with an elbow, takes Travis down. Lead Mike Miller. Double up right fist on Billy Travis. Heads him in the rib cage there. Going after Billy Joe. Look at Travis fighting his way back. Whoa, did he nail him with a right hand that time.
Great uppercut there by Billy. There's another one. Caught him right under the chin.
Caught him good in there. Slams Miller into the turnbuckle. See, he's slamming Miller there right into that turnbuckle. Billy comes back with another uppercut on Miller. Pin cover. Two.
I thought maybe he had him there. He'd softened him up over on the turnbuckles and then dropped him to the mat, but just couldn't quite hold him. This Miller's big and tough. Had him down small package.
He's got him. One, two. Miller reverses. Travis rolls over. Right, I just kind of rolling on the mat there. Now Travis is on top.
Referee just having to count whoever's shoulders are down. Tough situation for the referee as they're rolling each other back and forth. The small package was not a perfect one, and the opponent was able to reverse it. And they reversed each other three or four times there, but no three count. They're still going.
They rolled up in that for quite a while in there. Travis goes to work on that left arm of Mike Miller there now. Twisting the arm of Miller and pulls those to that left arm. Trying to wear him down. Billy Joe still holding on. Oh, Miller takes him, throws him right between the ropes. Look at Lauren Davenport over there. Just stomping on Travis. Our time is beginning to be a factor. This bout just to the expiration of time. Travis going out to Lauren. He's got Lauren Davenport. Oh, Miller caught him from behind.
Yeah, Miller dropped off that apron, and that stopped that. Billy Travis had his sights set on Lauren Davenport, but once again, she escapes thanks to Mean Mike Miller. The match continues. Travis has pretty much had the upper hand, but this one has been a pretty even match all the way.
Only a few seconds remaining, too, Dave. Time is beginning to be a big factor here now. 5 seconds remaining in the bout here. Miller picks Travis up, slams him down. That's going to do it. Time's up. Time has expired.
That's going to have to do it for that one. They continue going at each other, but the match is over. The time has expired. Guarantee you this, Corey. These two will meet again sometime, as this battle will certainly continue. We'll be back with more from the USWA after this. Don't forget, Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum, big seven tournament match to determine who goes after the Southern heavyweight title, which is now held by Dr. Tom Pritchard. Opening match in that tournament, Billy Travis will be going against Mean Mike Miller right there. Hey, that's right. Slipped my mind for a moment. So that will continue. Lauren Davenport, of course, in Mean Mike Miller's corner. Then it's going to be the Hornet going against Mike Samples. Following that, you got Moondog Spike against Tony Falk. Brian Christopher against Eric Embry. And yeah, I'm running ahead there. Next one is Brian Christopher against Eric Embry. Then we'll have the semifinals and then the finals to determine the winner. And the winner will wrestle Dr. Tom Pritchard for that title. Unified World Heavyweight title match coming up after that. You got Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert going against Rick Morton. That should be a great match with a unified world title at stake.
You may have a new world champion there, too.
That's right. And then following that, the World Tag Team title match. Anything goes. Richard Lee's hair at stake. Jeff Jarrett and Jerry Lawler going against the Moondogs with Richard Lee. It all happens Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. We hope you'll be right there at ringside. We hope you'll be joining us next week, too. Until then, for Corey Macklin, I'm Dave Brown. So long, everybody.